I have here today, November 29th, 2014, is an Elgin timer, which they call the nickname the jitterbug. Because it really moves fast. Let's see if we can zoom in. Of course we can zoom in. Yeah, that's the dial. Each of these is a second. You know, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 10 seconds. And on the smaller register, what's that? Oh. These are, I guess it'd be minutes. Let me get a pointer. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 minutes. Well, let's continue. I loosened the covers. I didn't say it. It says something in the back, but it's all worn off. You can't read it. I don't know what it says. I don't care right now. And there is the movement. And when you look at this, you may say, hey, where's the balance? It's there. It's real tiny. It's like the wristwatch balance or something. I don't know if we can get a... Yeah, you can see some of the little weights there. It's very tiny. That's why it moves quickly. So I'm going to wind this up. This thing has a broken mainspring. But it still runs for a little bit. I have to replace the mainspring. So yeah, I bought this. I was looking to buy one of these, and this one came up. You can see it running. Yeah, look how fast that puppy moves. Look at that escape wheel go. And that pallet fork. Look at those wheels turn. Yeah, this thing wasn't running. Things like that attract my attention. They said they had to smash the button down to get it to work, but I don't work like that. I got it, wound it up like you see, hit the button, nothing. And yet it, you know, it runs. So, as you can see, there's nothing on this side with regards to turning it on. So I figured, well, it's on the dial side. So I already took these covers off because they're real pain in the ass. So I took the cover off. And let's see if I can take this. Take the hands off to get the dial off. Okay. Let's see. Well, the hands are already loose. Yeah, how loose are they? No, they're not that loose. Anyway, let's get the show on the road. So it won't work when you press the button. And I wasn't going to smash the button down as hard as I can to get it work, like the person said. I tried it the normal way and it doesn't work. So let's see why. I already know why. I'm just doing this video to show you. This is like almost, this says it's a reenactment. Let's see, take off the hands. So I took off the hands because I got to get underneath the dial. That's where the, I don't have a parts container. Oh, here's one. I'll use this red cap. Because that's where the action is. I mean, that's, I don't want to use this. This is too thick. These are my, what's that? Hairspring collet remover tools. They're also good. Oh, that was real loose. Because I put it on loose. So I took the hands off. Get the dial protector out of the way. Oh, yeah. And then let's see, what can you see? Well, you can see, look at the height there. You can see all the stuff under there, so I knew something was under there. And you can see there's three dial feet. So we have to unscrew the, oh, where are the screwdrivers? Let's see, I'll use this screwdriver. We have to unscrew the screws for the feet. Okay, see, there's one screw right there. This tripod is getting to be a nuisance. Anyway, I don't know what you're seeing. Probably not much. So let me screw the screw. Oh man, that one doesn't fit. You know, it was fitting before. What's that? 1, 2. Let's try that much in. We go to the next one. I don't know what you're seeing. I ain't seeing much. I don't want to unscrew these little screws all the way because then they're a pain in the neck to get back in. So I'm going to unscrew them enough to get the dial off. Let's see if that was enough. Yay! So there it is. There's the dial. There's three dial feet. 1, 2, 3. And you got two holes there. 1 and 2. It's a thick dial. Brass, it looks like. You get out of the way. Let me get the tools out of the way. I'm not using these tools. So there is the mechanism that I saw underneath. I'm going to use a different angle on this. I'll leave it at this for now. This tripod is just... Let's see. Okay, well here. Either with the dial, feet went in. The little screws. And there is the mechanism. Can we get in and zoom in a little bit more? Oh yeah, we can. Good. Yeah, anyway, what was I going to do next? I'm going to get this out of the way before I knock it out of the way. So, there's the mechanism. So when you press on the button, you can see that the, I guess this is the crown wheel or something. Column wheel? This thing over here is all the action is. And you got some pawl thing there trying to rotate it. But when I press the button, it just don't want to rotate. So I'm like, well, why not though? Well, because it's not reaching far enough. So I, what did I do? I moved it just a little bit. And back to engage over here. Let's make sure this thing is still running by giving it some more juice. Because like I said, the mainspring is broken. So I put it so the paw will engage. So when I go like, oh wait, I was going to put the hands on. I thought about this video before I made it. To, you know, for special effects. It's not as easy as I thought it would be. So you can actually see something. Wow, I probably gotta use better magnification. What a pain. I'm gonna put the hand on backwards, I don't care. Just to let you know that it's working. That's all I'm doing this for. I'm gonna put the small one on now. So anyway, so I said, so you can see it's working. And then if I do it again, it stops, and I do it the last time. Well, it's supposed to reset. It did reset, but the hand's not on tight. Anyway, so I did the motion several times. It stuck again. To see what all these little parts do when you press the button. And what I did notice is... Let me get it so... Oh, now it falls off. Well, maybe I should... Anyway, screw this. Well, you saw the hand go around. Oh, there's a little thing that sticks out of here on the wheel that turns these wheels. Wait, here's a little finger. You see the little finger make contact and turn it. Anyway, so I did this. I pressed the button many a time to see what it does. And I noticed that if I keep a little pressure here, yeah, see, I noticed it, something wasn't right. So I watched all these little pieces move, and I noticed this one part over down in here. This thing. This thing here was not moving at all. So I figured, that has something to do with it. And I noticed that if I push it, it kind of like lines up. Well, let's see. It kind of lines up in that tooth there. So how am I going to do this? Let me get this out of the way. What are you getting? So if I noticed that if I kept a little pressure on this little piece and let this press in the button, everything worked. So there was a spring. There's a spring that's missing on that thing. And if you looked at it real close, well, you really can't see, but there was a wire spring sticking out of this piece. And it rusted off because if you look underneath, you can see where it was, and it broke off. So I had to make a fix. So my fix was, I got some copper. Either use copper or wire. I use this flat copper, like 2,000ths, 2,500ths thick. What's that, like, I don't know how many millimeters is that, 0.05 or something? Nah, it wouldn't be 0.05, would it? 1 millimeter is 40.1 would be 4. Oh, yeah. 0.05 millimeters then. Anyway, I cut a piece of that off, and I made a spring. And I figure, how am I going to hold this spring in here? Well, I'd use this screw. I cheated. Because, yeah, I don't know where you get parts for these things. And I don't want to buy another one to get a part off of it. So I took this screw off. And I made a spring. Out of that copper. Let's see if I can get it. And here is my little spring. Let's see. Let's see if it will focus. Will it focus? Yeah, that's my spring. This is a second generation spring. The first one worked, but I this one's better. So let's see, how do I get this in here? Let's see, how does it go? Come on. It went like this. This is going to be a pain in my neck. It goes in here. And the reason it's shaped the way it is so the screw kind of keeps it from falling out. That's why I decided to use this cheap screw. I mean, use the screw. So, what do you see? I don't know what you see. Anyway, I'm going to put the screw in. And this is going to be a pain in the ass. It's a pain at regular magnification. See, I got a shadow. I can't see. Oh, of course it doesn't want to go in. Oh, damn it. You know, because I'm using 3x magnification, and I do this at 4. Let's see, I have it lined up. Maybe if I switch hands. I'm trying to slide it all the way down to the tweezer. This is a pain in my neck. Well, I think I got it. Oh, I moved again. I got it. I think I got it. I should have turned on the auxiliary light. That's too late. So I got it in there. Is it in right? I think it's in right. Let's see if it works. That's my little spring. Yeah. Oh, this thing uses an oscillating pivot right here. Like on the ETA 7750. So now it works every time I press the button. It's not fixed, but it's fixed good enough. Let's see if we can get a close-up then. I think this video is not that good. Okay. Maybe this is the way I should have done it. Start it. See, now my homemade spring. You can see that little finger thing now. It's going to hit the gear. Whoop. And my homemade spring is doing its thing. So that's how I fixed it. Let's even get this back together. I'm gonna zoom in again. I should wear gloves. One of these days I'm gonna get gloves. Okay, dial it on. I see the screws. Gotta make sure the dial's all the way down, else the hands won't fit on right. And we got the next screw. Make sure it's tight. Yeah, it's tight. And this last one always gave me a pain in the neck. Make sure the dial is all the way down. And I have to use a different screwdriver. Because this screw is offset. Oh man, I don't even know if I'm getting that right. Oh, almost got it. Okay, and we'll get the hands on. I gotta put the tiny hand on first. Wait, this crud on the dial. Use a toothbrush. That's what I do with my old toothbrushes. See if we can line this up. Gotta be careful because I'm using metal tweezers. Get this out of my way. see. Yeah, we're going to get close enough. It's a little off. Let me get the big hand, the big second hand. Let's see. What a pain. See, the problem with these chronograph hands, you know, you gotta line them up really good. It's not like a time-only watch where, it could be a little off, no one's gonna care. But with this chronograph stuff, you know, you want it to be, you want it to be good. Ah! It moved. Can I move it back? Moved it back just a little bit because I didn't tighten it all the way. Let's see what happens. That's good enough. Oh, let's make sure this thing is still running because, like I said, the mainspring is it's broken in two places inside the barrel, but you can still get some use out of it. I'm going to leave the cover off. This video has gone on real long. Anyway, so there it goes. That's every second there you got. I mean, just a little bit. And then the minute one. Oh. These are 10-second intervals at the top. And the outer one is 1 seconds. So what do we got? 20 seconds to go. And that thing books pretty good. It looks like it's sweeping nicely, but it's just, you know, it's making these little steps. And then I hit the button again. And reset. Let's see what happens when I reset. Yeah, see, I didn't have the big hand on tight enough. This. Which doesn't surprise me. Yeah, maybe I'll have to fine-tune it later. And plus, you gotta make sure they don't touch. Let's see, let them run it again. And it moves. Whee! 10 seconds. I got this probably, what did I pay for this thing? Like $40 or something? Because it didn't work right. If something doesn't work right, chances are I'm going to buy it. It's a sickness. And we stop it. And we reset. Ah, see? I have it on tight now. Anyway, so there you go. Elgin Jitterbug Timer. Oh, there's the bezel. Quick, cheap fix. We'll look at the movement another time. Look at that sucker book. Let's zoom out again. Some people say it's 40 beats per second. I heard 30. But I'm going to find out one of these days by taking off the balance and just moving the pallet fork back and forth and see how many times it takes to go to 1 second. Yeah, that sucker move. Can't get a good... Oh, there you go. Look how fast that is. Sucker cooks. Anyway, I think I've wasted enough of your time and mine. And, I'm so proud of myself. I'm gonna let this video go to 25 seconds. I mean, 25 minutes, I think. Or maybe 45. That sucker moves. Yeah, the mainspring. To get a mainspring for one of these things, they have a special mainspring for this. You know, you just can't use the regular... Well, I'm going to try to use a regular 16 size if I can't get a normal one. Anyway. Oh, now move. Thank you for your cooperation. Hope you enjoyed the show. Enjoy the rest of your day.